together when you're ready.
Cool. Meet me and me here in Chico, California, with this wonderful artist named Anna Fritz. Pardon me. We got some clips, some music clips, so you can get to know a little about what she's doing. But she is social justice and music and folk singing and cellist. And if I wasn't too sure, if I had stopped. You know,
suggestions.
There came some ska on there. He's like, wow, she's kind of
really amazing. So beautiful.
You want to know a little bit about? You know what song we got? The song for Linda Vegas. One song that you sang that was written by the woman from Sweet Honey in the Rock.
Yeah, Bernice Johnson Regan.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you can recite that first line, because that caught us, too.
So the chorus, so we who believe in freedom cannot rest.
Yes.
We who believe in freedom cannot rest until it comes.
Yes.
And that comes from, I think everything in that song are things that Ella Baker said. Mm-hmm. Ella Baker, who was a civil rights organizer and activist.
And there's a real powerful line that almost reminds us of His Majesty's line, where until the color of a man's
the name, woman,
yeah.
It was until the killing of black men, black mothers' sons is as important as the killing of white men, white mothers' sons.
Wow.
Yeah.
And that's
Ella Baker. Yeah.
And that's so long ago, and here we're dealing with this year. And
yeah,
here
we're still dealing with murder all over the place, state sanctioned.
Exactly. Yeah. So you have a really deep compassion. What I really love about your music is it's so like a transgenerational. I just saw how some grandparents can come in with their cool grandchildren because there's so much wisdom and there's so much heart. So it's like I don't say a nouveau folk, but it is kind of keeping with that traditional folk, that prophetic thing. And again, I'm talking more. Where is your spiritual, you know, where does that come from? Because you know, sometimes it is. You said you did believe in that.
It's a huge force for me in my music, and I mean I have connection to the Quaker community. I came up in Quakerism, and then kind of wandered away from it, getting more connected to like earth-based spirituality, and then have come back to Quakerism because it's an incredible tradition that honors integrity and community and equality, and like these basic tenets of Quakerism are things that I realized this is like kind of the foundation of my life. So, you saw tonight, you know, my solo music that I play has been taken under the care of my Quaker meeting as a ministry. I'm actually a Quaker minister, as close as Quakers get to having ministers.
That's very interesting, because we're Rastafari ministers.
Right.
I'm more of like a personality. He's more of a teacher, and he does a lot of box life, but there was something in us that was like, I'm one of Gene Christopherson's students, and so that's what that's what the Most High Elohim is, use me to use my body to praise, to share, to wake up, and also for myself to be humbled by, it's a way. So I want to say that in the spirit of things, that the spirit is there, and that, that you're opening up and building. Now, that also, we'll talk about this off, but I want to think of some controversial things, but what I love is that you still have compassion, and that you know what's happening socially in the world, so that even with your Quaker foundation, and I do find that, we grew up in a Christian base or that sort of stuff, and then we go out and see everything, and then be like, okay, kind of like that whole Ecclesiastes, wisdom is vanity. All that, and you kind of learn all this stuff, and you kind of go like, oh gosh, get on your knees, and you're like, oh, thank you for bringing me back, But in this whole turnaround back to Quakerism, is there something in the movement that you think, okay, Because, you know, every spiritual movement has to have, like, that elevation. So you're coming back. Is there something you feel like, okay, the new Quaker generation, or the new you, so what is, because that movement was good for them, and it still helped in the abolition movement and all that. So where are we now? Where's God making it in the renewed vision?
Well, I mean, a lot of Quakers are involved in, like, so many different social movements.
Wow.
Like prison abolition and,
wow,
you know,
wow,
the new the new abolition needs,
wow,
to happen.
Sure.
But I mean, I guess for me, Quakers are about continuing revelation. This idea that, like, you know, what spirit has to say is not something that was, like, captured in a book and now this is, like,
oh,
all it is.
It's
like we have a direct connection to the divine.
Yes.
And spirit is moving and alive in us, and so we have a responsibility to be listening to that really deeply. And it sounds like that's, like,
yeah, like the Holy Spirit does.
On.
You know, the Rock of Dashes just kind of help us, like you said, guide us and listening. And thank you. I mean, you basically said that. But it's that continuing of nonstop. Alonso, is there something that you want to maybe want to add to the
listening, but to the Word?
Yes, listening to the Word.
Because it's the ground.
Mm-hmm.
It's heavenly ground. See, when you're in the heaven, you have no foundation. So Torah, or the Bible, is our heavenly foundation, which grounds us so that we don't just take off, like, as you're skanking and you're elevating, which is progress, which is what we desire, which is what we will obtain through liberty, which is liberty to do what is right, but still we need a foundation to stand on, you know?
And
we
so,
and
you find that in the scripture that that's important to you.
The connection will allow for the proper interpretation that has been misinterpreted, which causes some of us to deny something that is good because others did wrong through and with it.
And the fact that the thing that now is also that updated version, like our computers, so sometimes we need that updated internally. You know, like, oh wow, it's right here. So other scriptures.
But for the record, as I see that you are doing, It's way better than most of us that are grounded in scripture, you know, because
exactly,
the doing isn't necessarily up to par with what the scripture actually requires of us. So, you know, there's a balance. It's not to, you know.
I'm glad you mentioned that because, but that was my last point when you had said I got so caught up with you before, is that movement that you're doing, that doing it, being in the spirit to make it happen. So keep doing that.
We're not colonists, so we allow liberty for ones to be free to express themselves the way that they have been, you know, connected to do so. So we force the Bible not upon anyone. That is just our,
okay,
you know, our basis.
And
we gotta leave. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Miss D. Hold on. College of Embodied Arts, making it happen, making connections.
Thank you all for
that. Thank you. All right.
Don't put that on. We have to put stuff in.